Okay, let's wrap up these general rules and talk about the last couple things here. The first one is allocation. So we have our overhead. Is it going to be part of this new project or not? Of course, it can be allocated to the new projects, but only if it's relevant to the project and would increase or decrease the cash outlay of the firm. So if you have a part of your warehouse that has you're going to use for this new machine that you're using, that you're trying to price out as far as an investment decision, you're not going to include the lights. The lights are going to be part of the overall overhead anyway. You're not going to include security. You're not going to include other things that would be part of the warehouse or the manufacturing facility anyway. You're only going to include the overhead if it's an incremental increase in what goes on. So you're obviously going to pay a light bill, a heating bill, a security bill, and all kinds of other things. If they're not incremental to this project, they don't get charged to the project. You just ignore it and say, well, we would spend this money anyway. If we're not going to get rid of anything or add anything because of the project, we don't count it. Second thing is salvage value. Salvage value is very important for many projects. The reason salvage value is so important is because at the end of the project, you receive this huge windfall of cash because you've gotten rid of things. Could be a fleet of trucks, could be a machine, could be the land, could be the buildings, could be all kinds of things at the end of the project that are done. Well, we just don't hold on to them and put them in a scrapyard. We sell them off and we take that cash as a positive cash back into the project. And oftentimes that is the entire profit of the project, is you've paid the buildings off, you've paid the truck fleet off or the equipment off. And when you sell those, you really reap the profits of the entire project. So the idea of salvage value or selling a lot of things off at the end, it's not just directly your product, but it's all the other things you used to create that project. Also, we talked about cash flow. Well, one of the things about cash flow is having enough cash. So we always are monitoring our net working capital. And to have any addition in size of a company, you're probably going to have an increase in net working capital. We need to have more cash on hand because we're going to pay employees, we're going to pay vendors, we're going to pay more bills. So net working capital, the amount of money that you have over the amount of money that you owe, is very important to make sure you have enough working capital to keep the business going with the new project included. So we'll often need an influx of working capital to start a project, and at the end of the project, we get to charge that capital back or give that capital back as an outflow for the project back to the corporation. So if you needed $1 million to get everything up and going in working capital, at the end of the project, that $1 million goes back to the company when the project ends. So that's an important factor that we need to include. And the last one is cash flow from operations. We talked about cash is king. Operating cash flow, OCF, equals EBIT minus taxes plus depreciation. So in our case, we're not going to go too deep into the cash flow of the situation. You can get into accruals and deferred taxes and so on and be very precise. Really what we're looking for in operating cash flow here versus taxable, accounting income is after-tax cash flow, and we add back depreciation. We're gonna be good with that calculation. You could get far more detailed into figuring out exactly what cash flow would be. But in our case, we're just going to use operating cash flow equals EBIT, which is earnings before interest and taxes, minus the taxes, plus depreciation. And we're going to count that as our operating cash flow in the problems that we do. So you could get more involved in this, but this is what we will use as our general rules. So that captures all of our general rules. There's quite a few of them. So keep those in mind as we go through the projects, and each one will have a little example of how these rules are applied. And then, of course, when you get to your own homework and the quizzes, you need to remember that these are crucial things to incorporate into your answers because they won't be necessarily obvious. So let's move on and look at our first case.